Hi, welcome to Grandma's German Kitchen. As you may know, my name is Jörg, and recently I became an American citizenship. Since 1st of July is coming up soon, I was thinking, you're probably grilling in your backyard and celebrating 1st of July. I want to give you my cheese dip recipe and let you know I'm proud to be an American, because I decorate the cheese dip with an American flag on top of it. You can decorate the cheese dip as I do, or you can do it different, or just eat it. However, I decided to do the American flag in order to show you how much I love America. 450 gram melted butter or soft butter, 400 gram ricotta cheese, 200 gram sharp cheddar, 200 gram parmesan cheese, and 200 gram feta cheese. Then we have a half teaspoon cayenne pepper, 1 teaspoon sea salt, and 1 teaspoon very fine grinded black pepper. And then we have 4 tablespoon Jamaica rum. And this here is for decoration. We need a blue color for the flag, for the American flag. So we take the red cabbage, and we have tomatoes or beets, ricotta cheese, parmesan cheese, and butter. Let's start now. So I put first the ricotta cheese in, then I put the sharp cheddar in, then I put you can make smaller amount if you don't want a big cake like I do. You can do half of it, you know. So let's see how that, I don't even know it fits in my machine. Then now is the butter in, and then we put the cayenne pepper. The sea salt. The pepper. And the rum. So we'll let that for maybe 2-3 minutes running. We want it very, very smooth. So you let it run. If you want to let it run 5 minutes, it's fine if your machine can do that. So let it run at least 2 minutes. Sometimes you have to take this from the edge off, because the machine doesn't take it from the edge, so maybe we mix it a little bit up. Oh, this smells fantastic already. It's so good, cheese dip. If I start eating that, I cannot even stop.
It's addictive. So good. And you can eat it with anything. You can eat it with veggies, with celery sticks, carrots, with chips. Even it's gluten-free, so you can have gluten-free chips, like veggie chips. So I think it's good now. We put it in our lot of dip. That's between 10 and 20 people maybe. If they're hungry, maybe 30 people. But it's a lot of dip. It depends how much dip they eat. I had my friend to taste this. He eat everything. Yeah. It's so good. So let's see.
So we poured everything in a dish and then we let it cool in the fridge for 2 or 3 hours, depends how big it is, then you can serve it. Or you can do what I do and go continue and make American flag on it. Or you can do some different design. Half hour ago, I took the dish out the freezer and let the cheese a little bit warm up, so it gets easier out the dishes. In order to do that much better, I should put parchment paper in my form before I pour it in.
To do now the American flag, we need white color, blue color, red color. So we mix for the soft butter. And we have 80 grams soft butter and how much was this? 400. And normally we need only 3, but since I experience now which one color we're using, so I need a little bit more. So let's see. Mix that soft. Now we can put this on top of the cake. I printed out the American flag, so we need a little bit the square here. Now I mark the area with my knife where the blue color is going, so I don't need to put the white color there. Now we put the cheese dip back in the fridge.
In the beginning of the movie I said with tomatoes, I made it always with tomato paste, but I found in my fridge a beets. So beets is good.
After we washed the beets,
we trim a little bit off the outside, the beads, all the bad stuff needs to be gone. So eventually we use a peeler.
Well, there's the beads. I didn't believe it was the beads. Good. Now,
we cut the beets in pieces and put it in our juice maker.
Let's see.
So my juice maker worked hard. He made the beets juice and the leftover, the fiber from the beets, I can also juice and put it in a stove to let it dry, and then I grind it later so I have powder, red powder, for coloring my cheese dip.
I prepared already this here. Now I can put this, dry that out.
My beet fiber.
Now we put this in the stove. By lower temperature, let's say 1 or 2 hours, then
there's our beet fiber from the juice maker for almost 2 hours in the stove, dried up, very dry now.
We put it now in a coffee grinder. Oops, oops. And grind this up. Now we try to straighten that a little bit out. So I have here hot water in order to straighten that out a little bit.
I printed the American flag on a little bit thicker paper, and then I cut the red stripes out, but I left a connection. As you can see the red dots there, I left a little bit connection there so the paper will not bend away when I put the red color over. Yeah, how I get the red color? It's easy. I took the white color, which was the ricotta cheese and the butter. Instead of 300 or 400 grams, I told you I have 400 grams, so I had 100 grams left over. And I put the beets powder in it and mixed it in my blender. So now I have the red color and can fill all the gaps here. That looks good so far. Nice red. And now it's a little bit where my blue area is coming. There's a little bit white missing, so we put a little bit from the white ricotta cheese and butter there. And to make this now a little bit perfect, I go with a brush and dip the red one and close the gaps from the red stripes. For our cheese dip, the American flag, we need the background for the stars, which is blue, so we need a blue color. And how we do that? Instead of buying a dye, we make it from scratch. Like, you need a little bit red cabbage and you need a little bit baking soda. So, I bought a very small cabbage because we don't need much. Put this right. Small pieces, and for the color we don't need the core, so we take the core off, and we don't want to eat the red cabbage. In this case we want to have only on a blue color. I will make another movie from my red cabbage, which is fantastic, everybody likes my red cabbage, but right now we don't have much time. 4th of July is coming soon, so we make it real quick. A blue color. I make a little bit too much, and you can make a little bit more at home too. You can always freeze that in case you need later another blue color dye for your food. So that's gonna be cooked for 20 minutes, and then we go from there. Was boiling now 20 to 25 minutes, and take that red cabbage out. So the rest we can put through the strainer. Here, get everything out. Good. Now we put this back in a pot, but be careful, it must be hot. Now it's blue, dark blue, purple. So now we cook that. The whole thing we cook 50% down. So let's see how much is in it. 1 inch. 1 inch, so it's a little bit over the hole, so a little bit underneath the hole, we have to boil it down. So it takes probably half hour to an hour. Okay, so it's boiled down, half of it, so I put it a little bit in ice. Let it cool down a little bit. Now, we have, it's nice cool, put it in here, as you can see it's a little bit purple. So now what we have to do to make it nice blue, we put a little bit baking soda, like an eighth. We need it nice blue. I think that's a nice blue.
Okay, we make a blue color now. We have here Parmesan cheese, but the Parmesan cheese needs to be more finer. So we put the very cold Parmesan cheese, almost frozen, in the coffee grinder. Make that nice, fine. So I think we have almost too much, but you never know. Now we take a little bit of our, I strained the red cabbage juice. Put this in. Now we have the blue color. A little bit too purple. So we need just a little bit more dark blue. We put a little bit baking soda. Color is pretty good. Now I took the rest of my ricotta cheese mixed with the butter in my bakery tube and put the stars up. 50 stars on the blue background.